A candidate who is not even qualified, does not have even the necessary experience, how that candidate can be summoned for interview?
So, uh-huh.
No. I welcome criticism even from those who are close to me, because that is what keeps me more careful, straight, and law-abiding. So I welcome criticism. I do not. And in fact, you see, I do not take action in a hurried manner. I give full long rope.
So it doesn't mean that you won't invoke that pressure clause in the university?
That I do not know, because after I go back, I receive the legal opinion, not to satisfy my ego, certainly not. But if this kind of thing, in the opinion of the experts, will again worsen the sense of discipline in the universities, and on that account, if I am advised, then I may consider. But not because I want to satisfy my ego, why somebody has spoken against me. No, they are welcome. They can speak against me. I told the Chief Minister, you can criticize me publicly. You have your dharma, I have my dharma to perform. Shreyan swadharma vigona, pardharmat suanushtitat. Swadharme nidhanam shreya, pardharmo bhayavaha. My only plan is to set the house in order. The position of the university is such, and I am saying this because a senior minister has said the chancellor is right. I am not criticizing him. Normal course, I have no business to say anything against any vice chancellor. If I want to take action, I am capable. I have the power to take action. Why I should speak publicly? But I have been forced to speak publicly. Why? Because this vice chancellor of Kannur University, he has crossed all the limits of decency, of academic discipline, and you people do not remember. In fact, when the CA agitation was, why I called him that more than vice chancellor, he is a political cadre. He hatched a conspiracy to get me physically attacked. Kannur University, I was attacked. Yes, incident. Later on, I received the reports from very highest quarters that in Delhi, people know this conspiracy was hatched in Delhi.
He was not involved,
he was part of it, because it is he who invited me. The man who has invited you, you are attacked, and he does not even write a report about it. What does it show? You tell me, what does it show? I will read you out. You can heckle Prime Minister in the meeting, you can heckle any political person. But the IPC says that whoever with the intention of inducing or compelling the President of India or the Governor of any state to exercise or refrain from exercising in any manner any of the lawful power of such President or Governor